In this short video, I'd like to show you how to create a mind map using the GoConqr website. Once you've registered and logged in, just click on the Create button that you'll see in the top left-hand corner. Click on the mind map option and you'll be taken to that screen. So you just double-click on there to enter text, and what I'm going to try to do is to quickly recreate the basics of a simple mind map I used with some students last year about the different types of fear they had to describe in a short novel that they were reading. The novel was called Pigeon English, and they had to organise their ideas around the different types of fear that were being explored within the novel. So to add other ideas to the mind map, you just click on the plus sign and draw the node to the right there. And the character in the novel was felt threatened by some intimidating adults, so that was one of the areas to explore. If we add, just go back to that central node, click on the plus sign, draw out another node, and the other fear was being bullied. Oops. By other boys. So, to add a bit of interest and colour to the mind map, you can actually colour code different strands of the mind map. Okay, so that if I were to add another node to that one, that would also be coloured orange. So you could see how we could quickly use this very simple but very neat mind mapping tool to organise a range of thoughts in preparation for writing. So there were actually four types of fear that were being explored, or that the student wanted to explore in her piece of writing, and I'll actually show you the full mind map at the end of this video. But let me just show you one or two other features. If you want to add information to these smaller nodes, you'll see there's a little option here, a little note icon there, and if you click on that, you'll see you've got an option there to add a little notelet that you can use. This is where you can make notes. So it could be that if you wanted to copy down a quote that was very relevant to that character, or another idea that you'd like to explore, that's a very neat function there. So when you click back to the node, it closes up, but then when you click on that icon, it's there. If you want to add another page, you just click on the plus sign, then that will give you more pages, more space. Okay. Then you just click on that little arrow to take you back. Down in the left-hand corner, you've got a zoom function, which enables you to obviously zoom in or out. And in this toolbox at the top, you can change the background colour. You can insert images if you want there. If you highlight one of the nodes, you've got options to change the font in there, turning it to italic. You can change the font style, you can change the size of the print, the size of the font, and also you can change the colour. So I think the mind mapping function within the GoConqr website has got all sorts of features that are interesting and engaging, and could be really useful for learners to explore and use when they're planning piece of writing, because I think it's often in the planning stage of writing that students perhaps don't spend as much time as they should in order to produce the in order to produce pieces of writing that have got real structure and quality. So a bit of software, mind mapping software, can help students to organise their ideas before they start writing their rough draft. What I'd like to do quite quickly is to show you the more or less finished mind map that I did with a student last year. So to do that, I need to get back to the dashboard. So if I just click there and then click on the G icon, that takes me back to my dashboard. And then I organise resources under different subject headings. So if I click on subjects and then go to GCSE English, you'll see in my folder I have the mind map that we used last year. And again, you've got the option to move the mind map in or out, and you can see here where the student had begun to organise their ideas. They had put down the name of one or two characters they wanted to describe, and they'd also added some notes as well. So you could see how that mind map was used to organise some ideas prior to writing. And finally, the last but very interesting feature is that these mind maps can be played. If you'll see that there's a play button here, and so if students had to give a presentation of some sort and they wanted to organise their ideas in a mind map, they could actually use the mind mapping tool within the GoConqr website as a way to present their ideas. So if I just click on the play button, it will play and it will move around and present these different nodes in a clockwise sequence. You can speed up and slow down the playback. I'll just see if I can record that feature in this video. You could see how it then kind of moves around the screen, and at any point I could stop the mind map like that, click pause and then click play. So you could see that it could be a really useful feature that some students might like to use as part of a presentation. It's moving fairly quickly now, but you could slow that that playback speed. You could slow that speed down if you wanted to. So in this video, I've tried to show you some of the basic features of how to create a mind map in a way that students can use in preparing for a writing task, but also how they might be able to use the mind map as a presentation tool as well. I hope that's been useful.